Yeah, the dangers is what make it fun. I guess you could call me an adrenaline junkie in a sense. We are pushing 160, 180 depths well beyond recreational limits. So we're following military tables. And basically, that is pushing your body to the extreme limits. If you mess up, you're simply dead. Going down to 180 foot, shooting the biggest fish out there, maybe the biggest black grouper in the entire world. And just being able to chase those fish and see them is just absolutely incredible. It's something that you really don't get to see any other way.
It's honestly a perfect day offshore because we got the wind, we got a little bit of a southwest wind right at our back as we're headed off. We're dying right about the time and we're coming right back in.
So why is it when the wind blows like that, it's good direction to not make big waves? And why is it?
Well, when it's at your back, you barely even feel the waves, and that way you don't have water splashing up on it. It's more comfortable, right?
No seasickness. We're not going for dizziness.
For you Colorado boys, you know.
Yeah, I need that.
We don't want you getting sick on us.
No, no sickness today. We are currently trying to catch some baits so that we can go offshore. My man Jason here throwing the perfect pancakes.
Serving them up.
We've thrown about 10 throws, got some bait. As Greyson would say, it's better to need them and not have them.
Better to have it and not need it.
Yeah, that's the one. Yeah, have it, not need it. Need it, not have it. Words aren't coming perfectly. 3 a.m. in the Everglades was a little rough.
He's got seaweed.
Seaweed. We're with Greyson Dixon and company. We're going to run nearly 90 miles into the ocean to learn about how our water qualities inshore affect the fishing and spearfishing at nearly 160 feet deep offshore. Getting ready to start fishing here. Grayson, give us a rundown of what we're doing.
We're on about 125 foot of water. It's a pothole. It's like a little limestone erosion cutout. And there should be a whole lot of fish. We're marking really good, so we're gonna drop some baits down and hopefully catch some.
Coming up. Oh, he's wanting to go down, boys.
I felt it hit, I locked it up.
Oh, he ain't coming up.
That's what we wanted here, boy.
Woo!
Did I not tell you?
Yeah, you told me. That's what I'm talking about.
First fish.
Good work, look at that thing. Fish number one, in the box, baby, in the box.
We call that luck right there, okay?
Call it what you want, but I got a fish in the box and you don't.
All right. Going back in. Very beautiful entry. 5 out of 10 on the splash.
Oh, look at that thing.
I'm attempting to tie a knot, dude.
This guy ties knots. How old were you when you learned how to tie your shoe?
I don't want to answer that question. Pretty old.
Because he still doesn't know.
I still don't know the fast
one. What was the deal with the grass offshore, you said?
Oh yeah, I was going to say, this is it right here. This is the same stuff.
Sargasm.
Yeah, it's a sargasm. I mean, the crazy thing with it is when it's like this and it's in even an acre or a couple acre size, it's great for the environment. But with the size of the one coming here being 5,000 miles wide, it's so
there's a 5,000 mile wide mat coming to Florida.
5,000 miles wide, 300 miles width, and it's so thick that nothing can survive in it.
Red tide is an algal bloom that naturally occurs but has been enhanced by human intervention, pollution, nutrients. It creates a massive problem for us here in Southwest Florida. It kills everything. It's incredibly damaging to the environment, and it's another reason why water quality is so important. And we need to take measures to fix this as soon as possible in order to for the best for our fish and everybody here. Everything depends on water. We gotta get it right.
There's a big school of bait over there that they're all chasing around. They slam their tail in the water, it knocks the fish unconscious so they go eat it. Watch.
Watching Greyson and his friends do what they're really, really talented at, something that they're very, very passionate for, and understanding how it affects, how our conservation inshore affects them. These guys are duck hunters too. They care about, they put their time and effort into water conservation because they know it affects such a bigger picture.
Whoa, oh, that's a big AR.
Damn, that's a big AR. This would be a lesser.
You could put that as bait.
Amberjack.
Look how the name is an almaco.
That's an almaco.
I think they're
both
the same thing.
Nice, the waves do the work for you. Take him for a rip, dude. Take him for a rip.
That's a
spot
almaco.
Yeah,
this is a
20-pound
albacore right here.
Jack, we ain't done yet.
Up.
Come on.
Let him run, baby. Let him run.
Oh, smoke. That's a good.
Arm's falling asleep. Cool, right?
Duggan, there's blacks here. I think so.
Oh my god, that's what happened. You were set at 50% in the last one.
What's that mean?
50% mix. Oh. I don't even know if that's a thing. Yeah, now you're at 22. That's fine.
That's not good.
Yeah, that's
the best tank you ever had.
Yeah.
I should have had that one.
Set you at 3 minutes, departure, and 160, your alarm will go off. So if you hit that, you'll know to go up.
10 seconds.
At 220, oxygen becomes toxic and your body will start to convulse, and you'll be so narked out, you'll have nitrogen narcosis, which is essentially being drunk, is the best way to put it. Your brain does not function correctly. And that's how so many people die. It's a euphoric state, and all of a sudden you're convulsing and dying at 220 foot of water. We definitely pushed the envelope to its breaking point. Spearfishing absolutely makes you a better fisherman and waterman in general, just because you understand fish behavior in a way that you never could just by putting bait in the water. You understand how fish habitat works and where certain fish are gonna like to hide out and hang, whereas fishing is just it's a different ball game. Just spearfishing lets you become more scientific about where you're going and what you're targeting and how.
Mm.
sharks!
In the essence of camaraderie, diving is one of the most dangerous things you can possibly do. So you want to be able to trust the guy sitting next to you. It's just like anything where you're endangering your life, you need to trust that guy that's backing you up. That's why we keep our crew so tight, the people we go with. Our lives are in the other person's hands. If something goes wrong, they're the only person that can save you. So it's really important to be able to trust that guy sitting next to you.
I'm gonna go down. There's gonna be hopefully 20 black groupers sitting above that hole. Gonna wait till one tucks up inside of there. And he's gonna be quivering in fear. And then slide in there, get another hole, flashlight, powerhead. Right there. Lights out.
Perfect.
Set him up. Maybe we'll get two or three. I don't know.
Yeah, on it here. Let him ride.
See ya, boys. Little sardine for good luck, brother. See ya.
Going down to 180 foot, shooting the biggest fish out there, maybe the biggest black grouper in the entire world. And just being able to chase those fish and see them is just absolutely incredible. It's something that you really don't get to see any other way.
All right, what do we got here, boys?
Got two big old black grouper and a nice big scamp.
Sure scamp?
Yeah, beautiful fish.
Oh boy, it's a heavy load. Oh my hand. Oh my hand.
That's a big damn. Ooh.
Woo!
Producing.
Solid, boys.
Dude, what happened down there?
We killed everything. Killed them all.
Who shot them?
Jason shot one.
That baby Jason.
Yeah, shot one of that blacks. Finally.
Here, good job, I got it.
The Florida ecosystem is something that's absolutely incredible. What happens at Lake Okeechobee that flows down into the Everglades, then into inshore, and then walking it all the way offshore, it's all connected. So as water conservationists, we have to be mindful of how we affect different ecosystems along the way, because it eventually hits the last of the chain. And as we saw here, if we don't take care of it inshore, offshore, these guys aren't gonna have huge trophy grouper to chase after. So it's important for us, even if you don't hunt or fish, or honestly anything in between, we are all taking from this land and this earth. So it's important to give back at every step of the way, because in some form or fashion, you affect something that affects something else, and it causes a chain reaction. Conservation is simply something that we can't avoid, and that every single person needs to be in on to make sure that it's here for as long as humanly possible. If you want a way to support conservation that affects the bigger picture, check out these one-of-a-kind custom t-shirts that we're coming out with. Got Grayson's Big Black on there, the Spearman. Support water conservation and Ducks Unlimited. Check them out.
Yes, sir. Do it.
Got a male model here.